We did it, everyone. I say we, but you all did it 30 days in a row with 1,000 likes. Absolutely incredible. Thank you all very much. We're going to keep counting it. I figured we're going to have one streak already. Why not? Let's just see the strength. And I'm sure that a lot of people pretty much already saw that one coming. So thank you, everybody. I'm going to keep counting the like streak, and let's just see how far it gets. I have a feeling that it's going to last for a long time, as I hope it does, because obviously it does help out the channel quite greatly, and it's just a lot of fun. At this point, we've had 30 days in a row with 1,000 likes or more, usually averaging around 1,500 likes around there. So that is incredible. Thank you all very much. 206 Eden wins in a row. Husky and I are preparing to record our game videos shortly, and I will let you all know well in advance when that video will go live here on YouTube. CJ is gonna be 8 Bravo 79741 Mike. We've got the compass along with Fate's Reward, and we also have the scapular or the ventricle laser razor. Apparently we rolled. We must have D100 into Eden's Blessing at one point on the last run. That's the reason why we have an extra item here. Don't really care too much about Mom's Pad. Of course, it is nice having the Ventricle Razor. We also have base Stardock Eyes and starting... Wow, I can't even... I am... Today, look, I'm really excited that the like streak has hit 30. It's incredible. I just got done moving an entire, like, bedroom's worth of furniture and dust and everything all over the place. My brain is currently inundated with just stuff that probably has never seen the light of day. So dusty in there. But... yeah. So we have the Ventricle Razor along with Fate's Reward. Our tiers are great. Damage is god-awful. Movement speed is also bad. I would say our range is okay. But what's nice about the Ventricle Razor is that you can sort of like cheat your way out of pretty much any single room that you want. Like challenge rooms, boss rush. It's not really an item that you see me use a whole lot, just because I normally have an item that I consider something better, fairly often. And yeah, we have Isaac's base starting health is what I was trying to blurt out there before my brain was like, we're going to lock up and just not do anything. All right, we also have this Ahwa's rune. I mean, Ragman. Non-champion Ragman shouldn't be too problematic. I'm not usually a huge fan of Fate's Reward, but here it is actually going to help out with our DPS quite a bit, because obviously our tiers rate is good, but our raw damage is just bad. Our shot speed is also pretty poor. 0.89 is really bad. It's not super terrible, but it's just terrible. There's varying degrees of terrible right now, and right now we're on the lower end of the spectrum. And of course, the compass, if you don't know what the compass does, it will show us the room icons on the minimap. And that will indicate, give you an idea roughly of where everything is. I mean, you know where it is, but the path isn't always as clear. I'm very excited that I get to spend some time with Husky. We don't get to spend a lot of time together these days. And by together, I mean like, you know, on like a voice call or something like that. We're going to get the blue cap, which is going to give us a nice tears up. But again, unfortunately, we don't have... I have the damage, so I'll use the AWAS. Just maybe we'll get a crawl space. All right. Head on down to the next floor. Absolutely amazing, everyone. Thank you again. 30 days in a row with 1,000 likes or more on every video. Well, on at least one video a day. It's crazy. It really is crazy. Get a bomb here. We're obviously looking for a way to get a soul heart to protect our deal with devil chance. How is this start super bad? I wouldn't say it's super bad. It's not incredible, but what's really saving us right now is our tiers rate. It is not our damage. Our damage per second, our DPS, is easily saving us. Now what's killing us right now is our movement speed. Movement speed is a real sore spot, point of contention right now. Alright, so we are going to have to bomb our way into the secret room, which is right there, guaranteed. And we do get a key. Look at that. Two keys. Now, I just did an Isaac lesson today, actually, the day of this recording. And we focused heavily on we focus heavily on us. I wanted him in particular to focus on getting secret rooms, because it's an aspect of Isaac that you don't really think about a whole lot as a new player, especially. But again, I wanted him to recognize like the potential of how powerful it is to give yourself outs. It's something that anyone who's ever played poker before, you know the term outs. You know, there are certain scenarios where you can win and then the rest are just loses or just losses. And the avenues at which you can secure a victory are called outs. So like, for example, if you needed a three of a kind and, you know, you're down to one card, you have one out left. Okay, we're just going to get double tapped by Blighted Ovum. Oh, thank God we had that Soul Heart. I don't know. I actually don't know what happened there. Did we get caught on the rock or something? I do want a range upgrade, even though our range is okay. And we get Death's Freaking Touch. And Rotten Baby. So, of course, I'm going to take both of these. And we're playing with some fire right now. Isaac, that face, though. We need to do something about how you apply your lipstick, buddy. Obviously, Death's Touch is huge for us. It does give us a nice damage up, but of course, more importantly than that, it gives us the best, in my opinion, the absolute best tier effect possible. It's piercing, it's damaging, it hits multiple times. I mean, it's just great.
Lockdown.
And we're going to head on down to the next floor. So, yeah, but overall, very good. I'm very happy, of course, to have Rotten Baby. Rotten Baby is a familiar that's going to be shooting out attack flies, which are going to deal twice our damage, or 1.5 times our damage. I don't know. It's something like that. Now, clearly, what we need here is we're going to need some bombs for the sole purpose of finding Tinted Rocks and getting a Soul Heart. It was unfortunate that we lost that one Soul Heart to Blighted Ovum, but right now, with our damage being what it is, we're okay. It's not a one run, though. No. It's not. Don't even think for a second. It's a one run. That was real close. Don't ever do that again. All right, Brain, listen up. You need to stop getting hooked on these little corners here. Because that was a champion, and that could have easily killed us. That would have. I don't want to speculate. And yes, by the way, I realized that I didn't have to do the mob trap room with the ventricle razor. That was real close. I prefer not to speculate about my death here at the end of the streak. We're at 206 now or something incredible like that? That's nuts. This is bonkers, man. So, obviously, HP is going to be at a premium. Getting a space bar item that will actually give us, like, a soul heart, like, Book of Sin would be amazing. Book of Revelations, Book of Shadow, or not, well, yeah, Book of Shadows, but, yeah. I will take my little unicorn here. As much as I like Ventricle Razor, I don't think that it's not something that's going to save us right now. And what my little unicorn does, it at least gives us a way out. If we have to hit, you know, our oh crap button, my little unicorn will do that for us. So, if you don't know what the unicorn horn is, basically it gives you invincibility for a pretty generous amount of time. I am going to go back and pick up car battery now that we had that dime drop. And that is pretty big. That is pretty big here. Excuse me one second. I was expecting a very important message to come out. And I just received that message. I actually have another. On my other monitor, I have the tab open. So apologies about that. Super secret room should be guaranteed to the right here. I would say it's about a 90%. And a lot of people think that those percentages that I just throw out are arbitrary, but they're really not. I'm not gonna sit here and lie. I'm not going to tell you that I remember every single room and every single percentage, but based off of what I usually know about a certain room, I can accurately say with confidence, like, the percentage of me thinking that it's there, you know, and of course past histories in the same room. So look at that. We are able to get a speed upgrade. I've never been happier to see a speed upgrade here. Oh man, that's beautiful. We also get a bomb and a key back. Head on down to the next floor here. I mean, we're rocking this one. Now the unicorn horn is going to make this into a one run. What would put this run over the top would actually be us getting like a good orbital, like sack dagger, and it's GG right there. Bad damage on the retaliatory silkworm strike. Best thing to do when you're going up against these, because these worms give a lot of people problems, including myself when I first encountered them. No, I am so tired of you, Cursed Eye. We will never take you again. Mark my words, I will never willingly take Cursed Eye ever again. Unless if I have marked. I probably didn't need to use Unicorn Horn here, but I just felt like it. It felt safe. Secret room is 100% guaranteed to be to the left of here. Now, we do have to be cautious because those creepy crawlers can actually hit us from there. Petrified poop's great. There's our secret room, and this could be good. Maybe. We're in flooded caves, too, so the value of the petrified poop actually goes way down after caves. You still get poop every now and then in the necropolis and in the depths, but not as abundant as you do beforehand. Yeah, this is just a confirmation room. You can see the arrow pointing down here. You see here the tip of there. There you go. It's pointing directly. It's pointing you right to where you can find that secret room. And I know people still make money. Like, Simvicta, there's, what are you talking about? There's no arrow. You have to think about it abstractly, right? You know, it's not, I'm not saying that there's a literal arrow there, but if you look at it, if you look at the shape and sort of the contours of the room and like the positioning of how the doodads are oriented inside of the room, then you'll start to see, okay, well, it's not an arrow in the sense of like, you know, like look at one of your arrow keys. It's not like that, but it is directing you towards a particular spot or a particular wall in the room. That's what I'm talking about when I say talking about the arrow. Okay, little Chad, we are able to get a deal with the devil. We get void. I will take void. Basically because it gives us it makes the best out of all the worlds. We get to have unicorn horn and we also get extra stats and stuff. So yeah, so void is basically going to allow us to copy any spacebar item that drops on a pedestal, and when that doesn't happen, we can actually take a passive item and turn it into something useful. Secret room is to the left here. It's like a 50-50. Again, if you look at this, take a look at when you're thinking, if you're thinking about the arrows, the pointing. Like, if you look at the ebb and flow of this room here, you'll see that there is a little bit of a pointer aspect to these blocks and these spider webs here. And with the tip of it being here, showing you exactly where it is. Now, again, yes, that is something that I arbitrarily started mentioning to people. Because it's what my brain... Whenever I see something like that, it gives me more evidence of the fact that there's a secret room or super secret room there. I'm not in any way, shape, or form telling you that's a hard rule that's coded into the game. I don't believe that it's coded like that for a second. However, the way that I perceive those signs indicates, usually more often than not, that there actually is a secret room there. And that's how I trained myself to learn, like, you know, you don't have to memorize patterns in the wall or that sort of thing. You just look around. Just look around and see what's in the room, you know? Hopefully that makes sense. That actually was a really good example of quote, an arrow. So, shard of glass. I'm not a fan of it. I'm going to avoid it here. Maybe we can get a damage upgrade. We got tears up and a movement speed up, kind of. No, we didn't. We just got a tears up. Yeah, But Shard of Glass isn't bad. It's just like, it's not what I'm looking for right now. Yeah, saw that one coming. Absolutely, we'll take that. The question is, do we take... I think we gotta take Counterfeit Penny. Or no, we left it on the last four. Never mind. Yeah, I was gonna say, if we are going to take one, take one or the other, like, now is the time that we switch over to Counterfeit Penny, but I just remember that was on the previous floor. So, don't mind me. I'll just be sitting here rambling about nothing. Ironically, I kind of wish that we had the Ventricle Razor. Or at least that we voided it. Sure. I don't know why I thought I was going to be able to kill that in time. Now, we do need to be careful here with the Globins, because they will actually deal a full heart of damage to you for some odd reason. Now, our damage definitely could be better. Again, Rotten Baby is helping out a lot, so is Fate's Reward. But the damage, like the burst damage that we're doing, is just not there yet. We need to get about double this damage before we really start taking off with our killing power. So maybe the super secret room will reveal itself to us here.
What do the arrows say, Sindicta?
Look, you don't need to patronize me, all right? Just because I cannot articulate how my brain works to you all clearly enough sometimes, doesn't mean that I, like, you know, I'm completely off base. Sometimes my brain works, it works a little better, a little worse than your average bear here. We don't need a golden key, especially for two bombs, so I'm not worried about that. Petrified Poop's actually going to come up big here, hopefully. Getting Eternal Heart would be awesome. A Soul Heart, of course, would be cool. Also, the Blue Fires here that could give us an avenue of HP recovery as well. Or we could just get nothing. I mean, that's fine. So, trick here in this room is if you find yourself fighting Teratoma in this room here, you want to try to break the... You want to try to destroy the Teratoma chunks over the black space. Because if you do that, then it will not spawn the spiders. Now, the Super Secret Room is almost assuredly in that previous room where we just fought Teratoma. And it's probably to the right of here. I wasn't 100% sure on that, but it could have been there. It just wasn't. Okay, so War here is big. Because what War will do, War will give us an orbital. And that, combined with the Unicorn Horn, is huge. Now remember, we have car batteries, so our Unicorn Horn is going to last a lot longer than usual. Did not get to deal with the devil, it's okay. We're going to head on down to the next floor, but... We look at it like we're in a little bit of a precarious position here. Which is true, we do have to be careful, Curse the Lost Array. But it may surprise you to learn that I'm not worried about this run. Even sitting at 1.5 hearts total, and that's it. Like we're 2 hits from a champion, just dead, end of the streak, done. But I'm not worried about it because I have confidence based solely on the fact that we have Unicorn Horn and we have Death's Touch. Little Chad will also help us out if we do get super duper down, like half of a red heart. Hopefully we don't have to deal with that though. And, of course, Void can also ball out of control for us if we are able to get, like, some good items. Like, getting Shoot the Whoop's always great. Book of Revelations, of course. Book of Satanic Bible, I should say. That one, I don't know about. That one, I'm not sure if that skull actually bounced off of anything there. I didn't move because I didn't think it would collide with that, but, yeah. But it did. It sure did. Really hoping for the God's Rune. Spectral Tear is going to be huge here. Way too good to not... They're way too good to void. Now, I am happy that we do have a Yarrow Rune. Don't get me wrong. The Yarrow Rune is going to help out. keep us safe, but I really wanted the gauze rune right there. Alright, that's gonna be a dead end. Let's go check over here. Hey, how you doing, Dingle? Unicorn poop, by the way, will give you a full heal for red hearts only, not for soul hearts. I wish it gave us full soul hearts, although it would be like one of the most powerful environmental objects in the entire game. Okay, so what is the plan here with the Yarrow rune? Well, obviously we're looking for blank card. Ooh, this is a boss trap room, though. I may Yarrow that room. I may Yarrow that room, but I'm not going to until we have a full charge on the unicorn horn. Because that is a boss trap room, so we need to be careful with that. Soul heart here would be huge. Got one. Okay, that's big. Big, big, big. Because of that soul heart, we may not Yarrow that room. Although it would still be a good idea since there's three chests in there. We know that at least out of those three, we know that at least one of those chests will turn into a chest that we can use. Because it's a steel chest. The red chest, obviously, we have no idea. We have no recollection or premonition of what's going to be in there. But the steel chest, we can safely assume, is going to have something that's useful, hopefully. Now, if you're wondering why I'm hesitating on using the Yarrow rune yet, it's because I want to find the shop and the item room to see if we actually do get blank card or not. If we get blank card, then blank card Yarrow, and I mean, that's the run right there. Need to be slightly cautious here because this is a champion. Secret room should be directly here. Again, looking at the arrow, see the tip pointing down here. I'm not crazy. I know it sounds crazy. Again, you got to think of it a little bit abstractly, but hopefully you understand what I'm talking about. And I've had a lot of people tell me that it's helped them out greatly, so... I will take Mom's Key. I will take this. We get the Mom Transformation. Who freaking cares about that? We have a locked door here as well. Four room is a global D6. We're on depths 2 here. Tinder Rock. It's a rare place to find a Tinder Rock. I don't think I've ever seen a Tinder Rock there. That's funny, game. You know what? I'm gonna get my spirit heart. I'm gonna get my soul heart, rather, not spirit heart. Super secret room is possibly to the left of here. It's kind of a stretch. I'd say it's about a maybe 40% chance here. Yeah, I didn't think so. Was that worth our only bomb? No, it wasn't. But it would have been if it were there. Alright. Yeah. I'm gonna go ahead and commit to the idea here. So we know that the other bomb has, or the other chest has a Mega Troll Bomb in there. Now these charge keys are nice because that's going to keep us safe from the Mega Troll Bomb. And it also basically let us clear this room for free. Yeah, and this is sort of the reason why I had a lot of confidence in this run. Despite us being kind of low for HP, like, yeah, that right there... Car battery plus unicorn horn plus an orbital that deals a pretty good amount of damage is real nice. Where in the world... Where did we get our item? Was our item room Ouija board on this floor? I don't remember where it was. I think it was north of here. Yeah, okay. Alright, so let's go fight Mom. Obviously, we don't care about boss rush because we don't have a boss rush... capable run. If I had a way to port out of there, I definitely would have done it a lot sooner, but this is not a boss rush killing run. As confident as I am, and I do think that we would be fine doing boss rush, I'm not reckless. Some people might think I'm reckless. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and put this here. Yes, I could have rolled this with a D4, or with the 4 room, but I'm not worried about it. Actually, now that I think about it, we did actually get this moon card, so we could have teleported. Theoretically, it could have teleported out of the boss rush, but eh. Now, I'm not going to use the void in here. I'm not going to use the void because it's possible that we might get a space bar item inside of the devil deal if we get one that I would want to void. Like, having Krampus's head is not that bad with void, especially with car battery. They get a deal with the devil, Polaroid, and it's going to be Krampus. Can he freaking call it or what? Can he freaking call it or what? Alright, so we're going to void here. Alright. No tinted rocks. Head on down to the next floor. One second here. Hopefully I won't have to alt-tab anymore. Yeah, we can steal this room here. This would have been a great room to Yara, obviously. Hindsight's always 20/20, of course. No, Isaac, don't ever do that game. Don't ever do that again. While I was trying to use the moon card, Isaac drifted over and picked up the pill right as I was using it, and it caused us to use the pill instead. So yeah, don't ever do that again, game. Because that's potentially deadly. We're not careful. And before you think, oh, you were just moving it. You're just trying to find it. I have never seen this wrath room, and I don't like it. That's some pretty shady tactics there, game. Putting a barrel right in front of the door against Super Wrath, of all things. All right. Alright, I see how we're playing this one game. Try not to cough on the microphone. Okay. I don't even remember what I was going to say now, but... Oh, yeah. Yeah, if you think, like, oh, you just moved and you're just trying to make an excuse for taking the pill. No, if you go back and rewatch that, I was hitting the Q key long before we picked up that pill because I wanted to teleport out as fast as possible, and Isaac dropped it almost immediately and picked up that pill right as it was registering my Q key.
Well, it's not that dangerous in Victor.
I mean, look, it could be. Imagine if we had nothing but soul hearts and that was a bad trip pill. Like, that could have killed us. And since it was unidentified, we have no idea what it is, you know. Now, it's a little sensationalist to think like that. And I'm not quite that cynical about it, but, like, I'm still not happy about it. Thank you, Rotten Baby. Rotten Baby's had a quiet game today. Hasn't really been making the big-time plays. He's made a couple of decent plays, but nothing groundbreaking. All right. Here we go, Brain. Here we go. You got to stop getting caught, man. I got caught against this corner here. You really got to stop that. It's becoming increasingly problematic for us. I don't like it. There was an invisible Diglett up there. I thought I saw a shot come out of nowhere. I thought, well, maybe the blue one teleported really fast and I just didn't see it. There's actually two Diglets here. There's that one and then there's the other one that's staying completely still right in front of it. He's behind this nub here. There he is. Oh yeah, I forget we have Spectral Tears. What am I doing? Where's the arrow? Here's Invicta. Well, I mean, if you look at the, if you look at these, this rock formation here, right, with this corner here being the tip, because obviously you could be like, well, this is a tip here, but yeah, but it's pointing, it's not pointing to a wall, okay? You also have this, you also have this arrow right here, this, where it looks like an E. You got this one pointing that way. Again, you might think I'm crazy, which is fine. People think a lot about me, and then, you know, I'm fine with that. It was a pro throw. I was kind of, I was wondering if it was going to be one or not. What are we hoping for here? Just soul hearts would be nice. Baby Bender. I don't think Baby Bender is going to really help anyone, but possibly Fate's Reward. Yeah, we are going to absolutely void that. All right, so we got a, it looks like we got a Tears up and a Range up. Actually, no, Shot Speed up. Okay. Yeah. Not even a question here. All right, let's do it. If you're gonna go all the way, then go all the way. And more damage. We did get a range upgrade. So now that we have flying, do we need to go back or anything? No, I don't think so. I'm so confident. Our movement speed now is right where I like it to be. We're actually a little bit too fast, but that's better than being too slow. And really, we're only one Tenant Rock away from being, you know, 100% fine. Someone's telling me that one of those is a health up pill. I don't know why. No, we're not gonna give you a chance. Again, if you look at this room, there's another arrow just pointing directly downward to the secret room, which is right here. Get a nickel. So this is a dangerous room, obviously, here. We need to take down one of the Gertie Juniors. This is why I say flying is always the best defensive weapon, the best defense that you can get in the game. Because flying keeps us safe in that crazy room. I'm going to try to make our way to the arcade here. Yep. Wooden cross may have saved the streak. In case, like, I'm not anticipating taking damage, obviously. I'm playing with confidence right now. Of course, again, confidence does not mean recklessness. I'm not going to take unnecessary moves and stuff, you know. I'm not going to play as loose as I normally would, but I'm still not worried. Even in this spot, I'm not really worried. Three Skull Monty can give you a Soul Heart. Obviously, so can Judgment. Wooden Cross, by the way, will give us a Holy Mantle effect. Once per floor. We actually had it not that long ago. Just need to be cautious of the fly that comes out. If we're wrong. You get an HP upgrade. Okay, so I'm going to take the HP upgrade here. Thank you, Three Skull Monty. Thank you, Judgment, too. Oh, okay. If you want to keep on paying out, I ain't going to stop you. I mean, when you're on a roll, you're on a roll. Alright, well, now we're not in the roll anymore. Let's bomb him. Thank you, Three Skull Monty. Now, could I have avoided the HP upgrade? Yeah, I could have, but there'd be very little point to. Just because, you know, you never... This, I don't... Like, again, I'm confident, not reckless. I don't care how confident you are in your game. You should always at least give yourself more than one hit to stay alive. You know, right now we have three hits. We can take three hits before we're dead. And I'm anticipating that being just enough time for us to get more HP. Now, the strange thing is on this run is that our damage has not really been balling out of control crazy. Like, at all. Did not get a deal with the devil. Totally fine. head on up as, yeah, we got ourselves a good run. It's a, this run's a challenging run, but it's challenging in the sense that, like, you know, we have to, it's a good challenge. It's not like a, oh, the game is screwing me over type challenge. This is more of a, okay, we have a problem with this run. Now we need to figure out, like, how to solve it. Don't you do it. Okay. Super Sloth. Only reason why I came over here because I thought maybe it would be Ultra Pride, and that would be nice to get the red hand, or the left hand, rather. Death card, sure. Why not? Now, the Cathedral is nice as well because, obviously, there are opportunities for you to get some more HP. We have to be careful, though, because we do not have Polar Invincibility. There you go. There's no reason to go off to the right to aggro those spiders over there. You want to keep them relegated to just one side of the room. This is a death room all the way. And we lost our wooden cross thanks to the cheapest mobs in all the game, which are the ghosts. I hate them. The ghosts are the worst. No. It's possible we could get a soul heart out of those two chests, but it's not worth the risk of doing a full mob trap room. Okay, so we have blue fires here. We have plenty of bombs. This is what you want to be seeing. I think there's also a tinted rock over there. I think. Nope, not a tinted rock. Okay, what do we got here? We got one soul heart. Two soul heart. Good enough. And honestly, I think MVP should go to Lord of the Pit. If I'm just being honest. Because flying has saved this run many times already. Way more so than Death's Touch has. And Void, while yes, Void is awesome, Void hasn't really had any opportunity to really truly shine on this run. Might as well go fishing for the Super Secret Room. This is always just a 50-50. And again, you see the killing power there, Krampus's head, plus Cuban meat. There we go. Yeah, we'll just head on up. I thought about possibly looking for, like, a full charge and maybe look for more blue fires. Looking for more blue fires would have been smarter because there's no blue fires on this floor. A little spewer, spider bite, purity, sack, dagger. How you been, buddy? I am going to take spider bite because it's good for crowd control, and I am also going to take purity, which gave us the movement speed up, which is not really what I wanted. So purity will give us a random aura, and if we take damage once, then that's going to reset the aura and turn it to something else. Backstabber can just go F itself. So is this a one run now with Sack Dagger? Yeah. Yeah, even though we don't have Polar Invincibility, we don't need it at this point. Because all we need is a full charge. All we need is a full charge on Void, and we've got ourselves. We are indestructible. And we will be able to do so much damage, like it's not even gonna be close. Wait, what? So you're seeing right now the reason why I wanted to get Spider Bite. Spider Bite will give a slowing effect that you see right there with that white scythe. And it's very, very, very good at controlling your enemies. Very good. To be honest, I'm not even worried about voiding the raw stats at this point. We don't need them. We can win with what we've got. Just get me to Blue Baby and I'll get you a win. But this was a very enjoyable run for the sense that we were challenged. We did have some bad damage. We also had some cheap damage. But this is one of the more strategical runs where you really have to think about. You got to think about what you're doing, the positioning that you're choosing to have, and you have to make big decisions here. I just lost Wooden Cross there for no reason at all. To be honest, I didn't think the spider was going to take that step, but that would be considered bad damage. Except Wooden Cross saved us. Thank you, Wooden Cross. Yeah, but I like these kind of runs. I know that some people don't like the, like, oh, you're giving us heart attack, you know, sort of runs. Oh my god. Well, we can only take one. And as much as I would love to have Maw of the Void, Dark Bum is a big old GG there. Not that we needed him, of course, but it is nice to have Dark Bum. Obviously, Maw of the Void, we could have made ourselves a little bit beefier and given ourselves HP. Maw of the Void is not guaranteed HP, though. Dark Bum is. You're guaranteed to at least get some HP off of Dark Bum. It is almost impossible for you to have nothing but spider payouts from Dark Bum for an entire run. I mean, yeah, it's possible, but it's extremely unlikely. We want to kill a Sloth last here so we get a card or a rune, if we can help it. I'll be quite honest, I thought that Lust was going to die there. I miscalculated. If you're wondering why I did not hit Void there, it's because I don't know how close we are to Blue Baby. I don't want to Void Mr. Boom. We had to do that here. We also have the wombo combo of Lil' Chad and Dark Bum. I don't mind doing that there because obviously we have that full charge. By the way, that red aura that you see here, you may have noticed that our damage spiked up really hard. That's because of purity. So whenever Isaac actually does take damage, it switches the aura. And with purity is one of the easiest ways to break the tears cap as well. Although it's temporary. It's all based on how well you're able to not take damage here. I thought we had another heart up here for some reason. That's the only reason why I went back. So Dark Bum, by the way, will take 1.5 red hearts and attempt to create either soul hearts or spiders. Or attack spiders. It's going to be one of the three. It's either going to be a soul heart, a spider that can hurt you, or a spider that will attack for you. And we got a dead end. Good old dead enderino. Leave it to us.
Nice compass, nerd. Curse of loss. Eat this.
We have that full charge over there. I'm just kind of done dealing with the adversary and Dark One. Thought there was another full charge. There it is.
Well, if you're so confident, why are you going back to get the full charge, Victor?
Look, I don't know how many times I got to say it. Just because I'm confident does not mean I'm going to be reckless. No, you don't get a 200 plus win streak by just taking like every single risk and not protecting yourself, you know. Oh, good. Now this would have been the perfect time for us to have Maw of the Void. I will readily admit that. Thank goodness we've got piercing shots though. And we are very, very motivated to try to keep the red aura from purity. We do not want to lose the damage here. And of course, we also don't want to go down to 1 HP either. Normally, this would be an extremely dangerous room, but again, Death's Touch sort of negates all of this. But yeah, that would have been a 100% amazing room for us to have this room as well, to have Maw of the Void. And people are going to look back on that like, why would you not take Maw of the Void? And it goes back to something I've talked about recently, less recently than lately, but... the idea that I have a problem with Maw of the Void because I tend to fixate on using it. So, like, when I have Maw of the Void, like, I have a tendency to be like, oh, I've got Maw of the Void, I better just use this instead of, like, you know, staying safe and making good ideas, smart decisions. But yeah, I'm not happy that we got sniped from that greed up there. Again, thank you, Spider Bite. Oh, I thought Dark Bomb was ready to go. And the good old dead end streak continues. We're just gonna keep on doing a full clear here. How does he do it? I don't know. The answer is I don't know. Gonna be another dead end here. I actually had to make that move. If I had stayed in that corner, we would have been hit guaranteed. So I had to take a risk there and go through, thread the needle between these, between Pink Widow, because that would have been bad. Dark Bum. This is a greed room. That just loops back on itself. We got Gertie. So as you see here, now that we have the movement, because we took damage from that greed shot, we have switched the purity aura to the movement speed. Yellow is movement speed, blue is tears rate, and red is damage. For future reference. And we found it. But yeah, this was an enjoyable run. Again, for the, probably not for the reasons that you may think it usually would be enjoyable. But it's good to have these kind of runs because it really does, it puts you in a situation where the only way you're going to lose this run is if you don't make a smart decision, if you don't play well. You're the reason why you would lose a run like this, because the game did give us everything we needed to win. It may not have given it to us all at once. But as you see here with this run, you can win a run that's this bad. This run wasn't good, but it wasn't bad either. It was bad for all the right reasons, and it was good for all the wrong reasons. But like I said, make smart decisions. Try to see how many outs you can create for yourself. Take opportunities that the game gives you, so you can exploit stuff like, you know, Maw the Void on Super Envy or Ultra Pride or whatever. Dark Bum, of course, Little Chad. It's like, okay, Dark Bum just means it's just going to be a safer pick than Maw the Void. And learn Secret Rooms. Yeah, so thank you for watching, everyone. Thank you for keeping the like streak up. And hey, the Eden streak rolls on. I do appreciate all the support. As always, everyone, thank you very much. Check out the links down below. New song coming out this Sunday on my Bandcamp, sinvicta.bandcamp.com. Until next time, so long, everybody!